The Divine Comedy is fronted by Neil Hannon, although there have been a number of band member changes. Neil has remained the constant force behind the group after signing to Irish-run indie label Syntanta Records. The Divine Comedy moved to London, where in 1990 they released a mini-album, Fanfare, for the Comic Muse, followed in 1991 with Europop EP, after which the band split. Neil's bandmates went to university, and Neil went home and spent 18 months living in his parents' attic. He spent his time sleeping during the day, watching old movies, and writing songs at night. The songs that he wrote eventually evolved into two albums, Liberation in 1993 and Promenade in 1994. Both albums received good praise, but Liberation only sold a few thousand copies in the UK, Promenade doing marginally better. It sold around about 10,000 copies of the single, of the album, sorry. 1995 was an introspective year for Neil, big words. Liberation and Promenade had taken 3 years of hard work. Now he finds himself fresh out of songs. He took 4 months out to write and then spent 8 months recording his next album, Casanova. During this time, he was asked by journalist Graham Linen to write the music for a new sitcom he was writing. The show became the hit Channel 4 comedy series Father Ted, and the music Neil provided became its theme tune. Reworked, with lyrics added, it made its way onto the new album as a song called Songs of Love. Casanova sold about 10,000 copies when released in early 1996. The record company decided to do something they hadn't had the finance to do before and released a single, the album's opening track, Something for the Weekend. As luck would have it, Radio 1 DJ Chris Evans was played the single at a friend's house and he loved it. The next morning, he played the song 3 times on air, extending his show 5 minutes in order to do so. Chris invited Neil onto his TV show, TFI Friday, to perform. I remember being in the audience, actually, not at this one, but it was when the late, great Barry White was there at TFI Friday. I shook his hand. Anyway, this was the start... Sorry, I'll just carry on. This was the start of a... Make yourself a cup of tea whilst I do this. This was the start of a roller coaster of TV appearances, press interviews, radio play, and real success. Something for the Weekend was a hit, as were the follow-up singles becoming more like Alfie and the Frog Princess. Neil, in his trademark suits and sunglasses, seemed the most unlikely pop star on television. Neil's next album, released in autumn 1998, was an altogether more somber affair. Entitled Fin de Solis, it was recorded in 2 weeks with the band, now joined by percussionist Robert Farrer and the Brunile Ensemble, charting at number 9. 1999 marked both 10 years of the Divine Comedy and the end of their tenure with the Syntanta Records. The Divine Comedy released their first album for the new label Parlophone Records in March 2001 called Regeneration, and their second, Absent Friends, was produced and largely performed by Neil himself. It was released on the 29th of March 2004. Coming more up to date, 2005 was a year of exploration for Neil. He put the Divine Comedy on a back burner and turned his attention to the long-standing interest that he had never previously been able to look at. He wrote extensively, both with and for other artists. Neil eventually found himself writing lots of songs for the Divine Comedy. The resulting 30 or so songs were whittled down to a more manageable sum, and the latest album, to date, called Victory for the Comic Muse, was released in 2006. So, got four songs coming up from the Divine Comedy, from the album Casanova and the 1999 album A Secret History Of. My featured group of the week, step forward please, it's the Divine Comedy.
I'm the darkness in the light, I'm the leftness in the right, I'm the rightness in the wrong. I'm the shortness in the long. I'm the goodness in the bad. I'm the saneness in the mad. I'm the sadness in the joy. I'm the gin in the gin soap boy. The gin soap boy.
Ba 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 la. Ba 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 la la 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 ba
Broadcasting to the community, for the community, by the community. On 92.2, this is Link FM. FM 92.2, pop rock radio with local news and views.
Pale pubescent beasts roam through the streets and coffee shops. Their prey gather in herds, the stiff knee-length skirts and white ankle socks. But while they search for a mate, my type hibernates in bedrooms above, composing their songs of love. Young uniform lines in uniform lines and uniform ties run around with trousers on fire and signs of desire they cannot disguise. Words as light as the birds in that circle above.
You know, when I heard that song first time, because I bought their album, The Greatest Hits, and that sent a shiver down the back of my spine. I love that song, Songs of Love, from our featured group of the week, that is The Divine Comedy. Right, what did I play you? Started off the four songs with Gin Soaked Boy was the first track we played, then played The Frog Princess, another great song from them. Moved into The Pop Singer's Fear of the Pollen Count, and finished on that great song, which was the theme, obviously, to Father Ted, which I love as well. I love that. I'm still watching now, and because I can watch it now because I got Sky. Gold. That's it. I can watch that now. And Songs of Love. Okay, there you go. That's the featured group of the week. There'll be another one next week.